हे गाइस क्विक, अरे वो चश्मे कितने हैं मेरे। हाई एवरी वन, क्विक अनाउंसमेंट बिफोर आई स्टार्ट द वीडियो। वी नाउ हैव अ डिस्कॉर्ड ग्रुप लिंक इन द डिस्क्रिप्शन। एनी वन कैन जॉइन इट एंड यू गाइस कैन टॉक अमंगस्ट योर सेल्फ। इफ यू वॉन्ट टू टॉक टू मी दो, देर आर स्पेशल ग्रुप्स दैट ओनली पीपल हु हैव डन सम असाइनमेंट दैट्स गिवन ऑन दिस चैनल विल हैव एक्सेस टू। सो इफ यू आर वन ऑफ द पीपल हु डिड द कोडिंग असाइनमेंट दैट आई गेव इन द वेब 3 रोड मैप, यू विल बी एडेड टू अ ग्रुप वेर यू कैन टॉक डायरेक्टली टू मी। And the more assignments you do, the better tier of group you'll be able to get and the better access you have to me. That way, I can talk to people who are genuinely interested in coding and also doing assignments that I'm giving out on a day-to-day basis. If you have not done the assignment, I will give out another assignment in this video and in every following video. Somewhere in the middle of the video, I will speak out some random thing that I want you guys to build. These are things I want built in the world, but I don't have the time to do it. And I know it's very easy to build these if you use the tools out there, which I will be discussing in the video as well. So use ChatGPT, use Stack Overflow, figure out. I'll give you all the jargon that's needed from the very top. And then from there, you have to build the whole thing. Tag me once you've done it, either in the YouTube comments or in Discord, and we'll add you to the members group where only close people who've done assignments and who are actually motivated to code and can also do a little bit of self-coding by themselves are a part of. So just wanted to say that. Link is in the description. Check out the Discord group. Things I wish I knew when I was coding. I started coding around 8 years ago in my second semester in college. I coded 3 years in college and around 5 years after it. In this video, I'll share how the landscape has changed over the years. If you want to learn how to code, what are the things that you should keep in mind? And if I was in college today, if I was just starting out, how I would implement my learning workflow to use all the tools that are available today and code a little bit faster. With that, let's get right into the video. So when I was in college, the first pedestal I used to learn, and I shared this with my friend Harnoor in a reel as well, it was my seniors. It was people who I saw working at startups or in FAANG in big tech. I saw them going to these internships. I saw them going to San Francisco in Google's office. And that was the initial motivational bit for me. Also, I watched Social Network. If you haven't, you should check it out. That's also a decent motivation for most software developers out there. I want to become like Mark Zuckerberg and be a billionaire by 19. That used to be the best way to get motivated. Today, a post-COVID world, people are not going to colleges. A lot of people have like completely skipped on colleges and are doing online colleges. I think that's great. I think that's the right thing to do. And the downside that comes there is you don't know how you can find these seniors and people. So try to find some motivation out there. I think personally for me, the best way I've learned, and it took me a few years to understand this, was I was learning very passively. I was learning because, oh, this guy got into this hackathon and made 4 lakh rupees. Oh, I should probably learn about InfoSec because InfoSec is where a lot of people are paid this much. So that's a decent way to navigate initially. And I think that's still pretty relevant today. The best thing is you can find coding celebrities out there on YouTube or in a bunch of hackathons that you go to. So try to find people and find that motivation. Even if it's not in your seniors, if you're in college, I'm sure you can find seniors who are pretty photo and then try to follow them. With that, let's move to the second point. The second point is learning new things. It's always very difficult to learn something new. I struggle with this as well. At work, I would be given sometimes like a random assignment, not an assignment, but like work. We need to figure this out. No one else is free. Okay, Harkiyat is free. Harkiyat, try to figure this out. And then I have to chew glass and understand that whole thing, how that's done in the industry. And as I said earlier, everything is available on Google, on GitHub, on ChatGPT these days. So you can always figure out what is the mediocre to good way of doing this. Maybe not the best, but enough for you to meet industry standards. And that's the best way to learn. Someone gives you an assignment, which I am going to give you now, and you try to do it all on your own, figure it out from the internet. The coding community is much, what's the right word? It's not better, but it's more open than, let's say, the JEE community. When you're preparing for IIT JEE, it's a very closed circle of people you can find, move to Kota, go to an on-site tuition, do a 9-to-5 there, and then in 2 years, crack that examination. In coding, luckily, everything is available out on the internet. You can find the right way to do something, for example, building a website. So in the last assignment, you created an airdropping website. And the assignment today is create a website where you can send any token to another Solana address. So a website where there are 2 input fields, the first input field being the public key of the address you want to send some Solana or some USDC to. Second field being an input box where you can select the amount. And the third field being a select where you can select USDC, SOL, any other native token that you let the user choose. The user chooses these, clicks on submit, and those tokens go from your wallet to that other person's wallet. Decent assignment, I think. Should be doable. Use ChatGPT if you need more help. Let me know in the comments. I'll create a very long comment explaining what's the best way to do this. But try to figure this out yourself in the next 3 days, and the people who do will be part of the elite Discord member group. It's not elite, but like, you get the point. I'll be there, so you can talk directly to me. So try to finish this in 3 days. And coming back to the point, best way to learn is learning something difficult and new that you've never done before. First time, it'll be very difficult. Second time, it'll be easy. Third time, you'll be charging clients a lot of money for something you can do like this because you've done it 3 times. So with that, let's move to the third point. Focus on the quality and not on the quantity. What that means is, I've given an assignment in this video. I will see a lot of people will Google, use ChatGPT, which you should, but make sure you understand what you're writing in the end. Use all the tools out there to write your code, but once you've written it, you should be able to explain it to me end to end. And the only way that happens is if you write quality code versus quantity code. So don't try to do 100 assignments that I give in this video series. Just do one, but do that really well. Once you've done that well, then move to the second one. Focus on quality versus quantity, because if you don't do that, you will be able to do this assignment again and again. But if I give you a slightly different assignment, let's say I tell you, okay, now transfer NFTs, you might be stuck. And also this time also you'll need ChatGPT, when you shouldn't. You should understand, okay, these are tokens. NFTs are also sort of a token. So you should be able to write that code all by yourself. The way to do that is you write quality code, understand everything that you've written, maybe structure it a little bit better because it'll be open source. Other people can look at it. And if you've written nice code, you might be able to find opportunities, people who want to write these websites to transfer tokens. So open source your code, write quality code, and also deploy it on the internet for everyone to see. With that, let's move to the fourth point. Focus on the project, not on the framework and not on the language. Again, you've been given a task, you need to do it. Initially, do it in any language you're comfortable with. Slowly and steadily, start to understand other languages, optimal languages, and why people use, let's say, strongly typed Golang versus JavaScript, or even TypeScript versus JavaScript. But initially, if you do that initially, right, what will happen is you'll get stuck somewhere when you're writing TypeScript code and throwing very weird errors at you, which you don't need to understand on day zero. On day zero, you need to build a website so that you get minor dopamine hits. When you create your first website, you'll get a dopamine hit. When you post it on GitHub, you'll get a dopamine hit. When you join the Discord group and are able to talk to me, hopefully you get a dopamine hit. And that's the right way to do it. Versus if you try to build it in Rust on day zero, most probably you will get stuck somewhere and then leave it forever. So my advice here is do it in any language. Don't focus on the framework initially. Eventually choose better frameworks that pay well. But when you're just starting out, choose anything, just do the assignment, get it done, and move on to the next one. The next point is super important. Focus on yourself, not on others. It's very easy to feel, oh, my friend is now in Google, and then sulk for 3 days. But trust me, world is really small. Opportunities are out there. If he/she made it to Google India, maybe you make it to Google US tomorrow. If you make it to Google US, maybe someone makes it to, I don't know, OpenAI or NASA. So there is no end to comparison. There is no need for comparison. The race is very long, and in the end, it's only with yourself. So make sure you don't spend even a second feeling bad, okay, this guy's in Google and this guy's in Facebook and I'm still trying to find internships. I know these are hard times, but people who will win will be people who have great skills. Today, you may be able to fool by using data structures and algorithms, maybe get into some job. But eventually, the work that you do will become most important. And I don't mean eventually as in when you grow in your career. I mean, eventually in 5 years, data structures and algorithms will most probably not be used as a metric. It'll be, okay, we need this job done. We need to find a person who's good at this. And then they'll find someone who has that skill. So focus on skills and don't worry about hack or, oh, this person got into Google with just basic preparation, or like he was lucky. Maybe he was lucky, but it's fine. Just get motivated from it. If you need more motivation, join the Discord group and find people who are still struggling. Some people who are doing great, be happy in other people's achievements. And eventually, trust me, you'll get there. Tech is too big, opportunities too big, too many jobs, too few software developers. So you'll get there. Just keep on doing and don't stop. And especially don't stop because someone else got in and you did not. Fifth point, very important, find mentors. Doesn't have to be a course that you have to buy. You don't have to pay for someone's time. You can if you want to. But generally by mentor, I mean someone you can talk to casually. Trust me, everything is out there on the internet. You don't really need someone for one-to-one guidance. But it does help if you can at least talk to a mini coding celebrity out there. If you talk to them, you get some motivation, or even a senior who made it to Google or like whatever your dream job might be. Talking to them instills some motivation, which is good for you to work that extra mile, work 2 hours extra in a day. And again, I don't think like using people's time for doubts or questions is the best thing here. you should use people's time for motivation. Ask them what they did. Ask them for whatever, a roadmap or like what were the things they used to spend time in, why they got into that company that might be a dream company, versus asking them simple questions. Maybe ask those simple questions in the Discord group. But when you're finding mentors, find people who you get personally motivated by, and then try to take 5-10 minutes of their time to get motivation, or like follow YouTube folks who like share their journeys around whatever might be your goal, FANG or remote jobs. The real world experience that these people are getting, the place where you can get, looking at the end of the tunnel, helpful. It does help if you're losing some motivation. So try to find mentors. If you can't, join the Discord group. Again, you just need people, man. This is not rocket science. You need people who are doing it. If you look at them, you'll do it as well. It's as easy as that. If you find people who are gaming a lot, you might become a great gamer. If you find people who are playing cricket all day, usually smart people come out of small communities. So let's try to create one. Join the link in the description. Cool. That brings us to the end of this video. Again, the assignment is a token transfer website where you can transfer any token on the Solana blockchain to someone else. If you already completed the last assignment, join the Discord group, and there'll be a few moderators who will get you into the other group in which I am in, and then feel free to ask me any questions. Whenever I get the time, I will answer. I'm not saying I'll be answering questions 24/7, but try to answer and figure things out by yourself. That's the whole idea. Again, me answering every question is not scalable, but you guys answering each other's questions is super scalable, and also ChatGPT. So with that, I'm excited for the Discord group. I'll see you there, and I'll see you in the next video.
So I was in the US for a month now. During this time, I met Harnoor as well, who's now a good friend. And just wanted to share that, like, when we're in college, it's hard for us to look 5 years down the road. But trust me, in tech, if you're doing even okay, average, and slightly above average, all the things that might be your dreams, or the things you might need, or you might feel like you need, you'll get there. I've said this a few times now, but find people who want to do the same. Trust me, if you're in that group, you'll get there. Second time, let's end the video. I'll see you guys the next one.